Well, good evening everyone. I'm Elsie Normington and I want to give you a very warm welcome tonight to this sing-along session. This session is called Take 20, which is 20 minutes of old and new gospel songs and sayings. And I hope that you're going to be blessed by this little session, just a short time of 20 minutes out of your schedule, just to praise and worship the Lord and have a little word of encouragement. Now, first of all, I want to say thank you to everyone that logs on. I've got many regular viewers that come on a Thursday night, and I want to say thank you very much to all of you for coming on to the Take 20 show. I also want to welcome tonight a lady from Edinburgh, and her name is Margaret Alexander, and she's been watching the show as well and been really blessed by it. So it's lovely to see you logging in, Margaret, and may God bless you. And Margaret was on the phone to me and she was telling me about a friend of hers, Irene and Colin McElwain, who live in British Columbia in Canada. And so I want to say hello to Irene and Colin tonight, and to all your friends that you've shared this link with. And I just trust that God will bless you as I do this little session here in Inverness in the Highlands of Scotland. Now then, we're going to start with a really rousing hymn tonight. This hymn was written in 1914 by a man called Rufus McDaniel, and this was a great song that was sung during the Philadelphia revival meetings. Many people were singing it. They were even singing it in the streets. Since Jesus came into my heart. So here we go. Since Jesus came into my heart. Well, if you've never asked Jesus into your life and into your heart, you can do it right now. You can do it tonight, today. You know, the Bible says if we confess our sin and believe in the Lord Jesus Christ that he was raised from the dead, you will be saved. It's as simple as that. Accept you're a sinner, believe in Jesus and confess him as Lord. So we're going to sing verse 1 again. And as we do that, you you may just want to breathe that little prayer right now and ask the Lord Jesus into your heart, and he'll fill your heart with the joy of the Lord. Here we go. What a wonderful change to my life. That was a great number to start with, wasn't it? And I love these joyful songs. You know, it's a great thing to sing joyful songs because it so lifts your spirits and lifts you up inside by focusing on Jesus and all these wonderful lyrics instead of focusing on all the negative things that have been happening in all our lives. Isn't that right? So we're going to have another upbeat number. And this one was written way back in 1948 by a man called Hank Williams. And Hank had been at a gospel concert, and he had been there with some members of his family. And when they were driving home, his mother said in the car, "You know, Hank, I saw the light tonight." And as a result, Hank Williams wrote this great song, "I Saw the Light." So it's a lovely song. You might want to clap along or tap along. You know, the Bible says, "Let everything that has breath praise the Lord." That's what it says. So here we go. I saw the light. Here we go. I wandered so aimless, like filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I am so happy, no sorrow inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Just like the blind man, I wandered along. Worries and fears I claimed for my own. Then like the blind man, God gave back his sight. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Here we go. I saw. Enjoyed singing along that one. I saw the light. And you know, I live in North Kessop and I look out to the city of Inverness and often the sun is just shining right over the Firth and it's so beautiful and it just draws my heart to God. You know, the Bible says, arise, shine, for your light has come and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. And so it's wonderful just to look to Jesus, the light of the world. He put the sun and the moon and the stars in place. He is the giver of life itself. And so it's so important to see that light. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. So that was just a great song. Now then, I'm just going to check on my wee dog here because she was having a lot of... Are you all right, wee Daisy? Hey, there you go. She's all nice and cosy in her bed there, sitting in the corner. Now then, okay, I've got a nice wee poem here for you today. And this poem is based on Isaiah 43. And I'll tell you the verse at the end of the poem. But this is what it is. Trust in me. Here we go. When the storms are raging, then trust in me, my child. My word will calm the waves, be they ever so wild. Put your trust in me, child, when the waters roar and foam, and you're adrift at sea, many miles from home. Don't be afraid, there's no reason to fear. Though you may feel alone, I am always near. I am watching over you, I'm holding your hand, and I will guidely safe you to the promised land. Your little boat won't sink, the waters won't overflow. This storm came your way so that your faith might grow. So put your trust in me, child. With me you are safe. I will give you my strength and the grace to be brave. When the waters roar and foam and you're adrift at sea, keep hoping, keep on believing, my child, trust in me. Isn't that a lovely wee poem? That was taken from christart.com and it was written by Bettina van Berenberg. And this is based on Isaiah 43 verse 1 that says, when you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And I just want to bring a word of comfort to you tonight. If you feel you're going through the storm, if you feel you're going through these rough waters, I encourage you to unburden your heart to the Lord Jesus and let him carry you through. You know, he wants to take our burdens as we trust in him. And that's what that poem is all about. Put your trust in me, child, when the waters roar and foam and you're adrift at sea, miles from home. Don't be afraid. There's no reason to fear. Though you may feel alone, I am always near. And sometimes, perhaps family members or friends or colleagues may let you down, but you know, the Lord Jesus said, I'll never leave you or forsake you. The Lord Jesus is the same yesterday, today and forever, and he's always, always there for us. So a lovely wee hymn there, I saw the light. Now then, okay, next up, this is another lovely song. It's quite some time since we've done it, actually. But it's a beautiful song written in 1950, and it was written by a lady called Blanche Brooke. And this is based on, I've told this story before, but perhaps you've not heard it before, where Blanche and Virgin Brooke couple and some of their friends were out and they were watching lovely sunset over the lake. And they were commenting about the beauty of the sunset. But one of their friends was blind, a man called Horace Burr. And he began to say what he was seeing. And they turned to Horace and said, Horace, what is it you're talking about? What is it you're seeing? And he turned and said, I can see beyond the sunset. And what a beautiful aspiration to have. I can see beyond the sunset. And we may see the sun beautifully shining on us in these cold winter days. But you know, it's so important to see beyond the sunset, that other side when we go to be with the Lord. So here we go, beyond the sunset.
Beyond the sunset, oh blissful.
I love to sing that song, and it's so good to know the background behind it, because there's oftentimes a really interesting story behind all these hymns that were written. So there we go, a song from 1950, 70 years ago, and here we are still singing it, Beyond the Sunset. Well, we're coming to our last song, and as I say, it's 20 minutes of gospel songs and sayings, and this last song is a real favourite of mine. I sing it a lot. I often sit here at the piano. I've got a piano here in my room, and I often sit at the piano and I sing this song, and it's called Great is Thy Faithfulness. Now, this is based on Lamentations chapter 3, and this is what it says. Through the Lord's mercies we are not consumed, because his compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul who seeks him. It is good that one should hope and quietly wait for the Lord of our salvation. So there we go. His blessings are new every morning. And when this song was written by Thomas Obadiah Chisholm, he wrote this towards the end of his life in 1923, and he was reflecting across all the decades of his life, and he penned this. He was actually a poet, and he got someone to write the tune for him, a man called William Runyon. And he wrote this because it was a reflection of his life, and how good it is for us to reflect on the faithfulness of God in our lives when he's carried us through these storms and brought us through the other side. So here we go. Great is thy faithfulness. Singing along to Great is Thy Faithfulness, a real classic hymn with fantastic words of hope. Tonight I want to thank you very much for watching Take 20, and I really trust that you've been encouraged by singing these songs and hearing some of the readings from God's precious word. And so I just want to say tonight, be encouraged and stay close to the Lord and do look after yourself until we meet again. Thank you for watching. Good night and God bless you.